all I have is this feeling that it is time for me to try something new in my life. This may seem so sudden to most of you probably, but it is something that I knew for a long time. Especially this year, I struggle with finding a reason to keep going.
PewDiePie's fiance, Marzia, just announced that she's leaving YouTube, and it seems like she might be going through a little bit of an existential crisis, but that might actually be a good thing. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. So what I like to do is take different topics from the YouTube community to try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So to get this video started, a shout out to my buddy, Roberto Blake, from the YouTube channel, Roberto Blake. If you're interested in just being like an entrepreneur or starting a YouTube channel, or you're into creating stuff, go check his channel out, great dude. But anyways, yeah, he messaged me this morning, he's like, yo, Marzia's leaving YouTube, you should check this video out. I'm like, okay. And like, I love it so much because like, now that people are trying to see me hit my like stride and my groove and like what's working, like so many people are like recommending stuff. And it's awesome, it's awesome. So now that the Shane Dawson stuff is over, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna pull the e-brake, I'm gonna dial it back, I'm gonna do like, one video a day now and just kind of do my thing. But like, my brain just does not let me do that. And I have three video ideas and like, I don't know, I think they could be really helpful. So I don't know. Something I've been talking about a lot lately with my girlfriend is just balance with all things. And yeah, like, I don't know. Even for me, it's sometimes difficult to find that balance. But I love putting out content. I love seeing how you all receive it. I love, like lately, the last couple days, like man, you guys have just warmed my heart. Like tagging me on like Instagram or Twitter or leaving comments and just, like I was telling Tristan this morning, like nothing makes me happier when you take what I say and you actually do something with it. Like that is just the most fulfilling thing on earth. Like I can't even explain it. Like there's so many reasons why I start out every video with we talk about the problem but focus on the solution, because I don't want you to just sit here and watch my channel and be like, oh well yeah, Chris made some good points. I want you to be like, yo, Chris made some good points, now I'm gonna get off my butt and go try some of this stuff. So anyways, I'm gonna be making three videos, deal with it. So yeah, let's talk about Marzia. So I don't watch Marzia. I don't watch PewDiePie as much anymore. But anyways, for those of you who don't know who Marzia is PewDiePie's fiance. PewDiePie is currently the largest creator on YouTube, but I think he's about to get passed up by T-Series, maybe. Anyways, Marzia just made a video about leaving YouTube. And there's two main topics. There's two main topics that I wanna discuss because there might be some things that you can relate to with this. One of them is living in someone else's shadow, and the other one is having an existential crisis. So Marzia is in her mid-20s, and I was actually just talking to a buddy over on Twitter because he and I were talking about having an existential crisis. And I was like, wait, how old are you? Because I don't know him like personally, we just talked through Twitter DMs. I'm like, how old are you? And he tells me, he's like in his early 20s. I'm like, huh. So I think, you know, especially because I have a pretty big audience who varies between like 18 years old and like 30 something, like early 30s, I think it's important to talk about these existential crises, because I think this is, my audience is a big age group where this happens. All right, so the first thing that I wanna address is Marzia kind of talked about how like, she had a lot of mental health struggles, right? Like she moved in with Felix and she didn't really know what to do. She left her family, she left her friends, all these things, and she was kind of isolating and alone. And that's when she decided to like start a YouTube channel and have what she calls her own little corner of the internet, right?
I had a lot of free times that I didn't really know how to spend because my friends were away. So I ended up in front of the computer a lot. And for the first time, I started realizing how much there was on YouTube.
And actually, I'm gonna drop some neuroscience on you real quick too. Something that she talks about a few times throughout this video is just making connections with other people. And she kind of realized that you can't just only do that online. And there's some neuroscience behind this. Like, I made a video a long time ago, but I'll just reiterate. Like, our brains are designed to be connected to other people. Like, one of my favorite subscribers, Psychedelic Feline, was like, hey Chris, can you do a video on evolutionary psychology? Well, I'm just gonna sprinkle some evolutionary psychology on you right now. So basically, back in the day, like, our brain had to evolve in a way where we would get feelings of anxiety or depression if we were separated from the tribe. So that let us know, like, yo, you're in danger. Like, if something happens to you, you're in trouble, right? So our brain had to evolve in a way that gave us signals to return to the tribe. This is why isolation is terrible, terrible for depression and anxiety. Your body is saying, yo, go be connected to other people. Get back to the tribe, get back to society. And that's one of the main reasons why so many people struggle with depression and anxiety today. In this technological age that we live in, more and more people are further and further apart. So I hope that makes sense. So Marzia kind of found, you know, her happiness by going out, connecting with people, traveling and all of that. But the issue was, is that she's in PewDiePie's shadow.
That it's about me needing to find my path, because for a long time I felt like I was following someone else's, and I think it's about time that I give myself a chance with something else.
And this is something that some of you might be struggling with. Like, I don't think you're in PewDiePie's shadow, but I see this especially with teenagers as well as people in their early 20s, right? Like, we all have our own life to live, but we're trying to live in a way that other people think we should live. Like, you know how I keep talking about, like, quit caring so much about what other people think? Like, so many of us, like, you know, we get good grades in school for our parents, right? We go to a certain college for our parents. We do these things for our parents or to impress people. We're not doing what we want to do, right? So next thing you know, you're miserable in your 30s or 40s because you became a doctor, even though you didn't want to become a doctor. It's just your family pressured you into doing it. So, like, when I went and spoke at that high school like a month or so ago, like, I told people, like, you gotta find your path. Like, college is great and stuff, but you gotta find what makes you happy, what you want to do. Does that make sense? So if any of you are, like, in that right now, like, you really need to step back and, like, think about that and assess it. And some of you haven't changed your path yet because you're worried about what your parents will say or what your family's gonna say, right? Like, who cares if your Aunt Gretchen is talking down to you because you decided to pursue your passion for artwork and she thinks that you should be, I don't know, like, some, I don't know, a lawyer or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, something that I try to do, when people are, like, judging me and stuff, I look at them, I'm like, is this person happy with their life? And usually they're not. And if they're not happy with their life, why am I going to value their opinion more than mine? Like, I'm gonna figure out what makes me happy, because if I do what they want, I'm probably gonna be as miserable as they are. Does that make sense? But anyways, so Marzia kind of had this realization that this isn't the path that she wants to be on. And it seems like she was a little lost, and a lot of us get like this, right? That's what this existential crisis is. We don't know what we're gonna do. I made a video about this a long time ago, about the existential crisis. Like, when people struggle with this, because I know I used to, like, today, I kind of just kind of giggle about it, right? Because an existential crisis is, what's our meaning? What's our purpose? Why am I here? What am I doing, right? And for me, what I'm doing, I have purpose every single day, because my one and only goal is to just help other people, right? Is to teach other people and give them hope and strength and all these other things. Like, that's my purpose in life. I found my purpose. So every day I wake up with a purpose. So my best suggestion for you to get out of your existential crisis is to really check with your value system. Like, what do you want, right? What is your overall goal with life? Okay, cool. Now, what do we do to achieve that? Now, with Marzia's video, she didn't really tell us what that was. She didn't really tell us what she was doing, but hopefully it's something that makes her happy. And it's gotta be scary. It must be scary for her to do this, but it's also, you know, amazing that she is. So the last thing I'll talk about in this video, which is not even a knock at Marzia, but I have a lot of new subscribers and I want you to get to know me a little bit better. But I don't see myself ever leaving you entirely. Okay? And here's why. When we put out content as creators, okay, I'll speak about me because this is not a knock at Marcia. When we put out content as creators, in some way, shape, or form, we are helping people, right? Maybe we're providing somebody with escapism, or it's a channel like mine where we're trying to, you know, provide tools to improve their mental health, but we're doing something for others and we gain this following. And for me personally, just because of the way I work on my mental health, for me to just leave all of you would be very selfish. Now, don't get me wrong, like I think in Marcia's instance, she has to be selfish, right? She has to be. But since I'm all about taking your experience and sharing it with others, I think it would be better if Marcia didn't stop her YouTube channel, she just pivoted and like documented what she's doing. And I think she'll probably still do it on like Instagram or Twitter or whatever it is. But I think what she's doing is so powerful. That's why I make these videos about other YouTubers, because what they're doing, like Garrett Watts, it's so powerful that you need to see what you can learn from it. So like Marcia being a young woman and switching her path, as scary as that might be, she's doing it to find this happiness. And I think since she's amassed such a following, she could really inspire other people to do something and switch their path as well. So my hope would be is that she documents it in some way, shape, or form. But for me personally, because of my purpose, because of how I got out of my existential crisis, Chris ain't going nowhere. Like, you might leave me, but I ain't leaving you. But anyways, that's what I wanted to talk about with this video. So I wanna hear from you down in the comments below. Like, what is your meaning? What is your purpose? Are you in an existential crisis? Like, let's have a conversation down below. Like, let's inspire one another. Maybe like what your purpose is what somebody else's is. Like, I know some of you might be able to relate to me. Maybe your purpose is helping other people or teaching other people, whatever it is. Like, let's have a conversation below and like offer each other suggestions and advice and all that kind of stuff, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for you with this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell because I make so many videos. All right, and a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing, and I got some new exciting stuff coming on Patreon. So if you wanna sign up for Patreon, click or tap on that link right there for as little as $1 a month, all right? But thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.